Students, we have started in our last video about chemical combination of law, that is two law we have discussed, conservation of mass and law of constant proportion. Now after that, Dalton gives a theory, it is called Dalton's atomic theory. And according to this Dalton's theory, all matters, whether an element, matter means what? Matter means an element, a compound or a mixture. Composed of small particles called atoms. I told you about what are atoms. Atoms are smallest particle, and atoms we cannot be divided further. So this is the smallest particles of matter. So that's why Dalton gives a theory, and according to this theory, all matter, whether an element, a compound or a mixture, is composed of small particles called atoms. So Dalton gives postulates, and six postulates of Dalton's theory are follows. The first postulate is what? All matter is made up of very tiny particle called atoms. This is the first postulate of Dalton. That means all matter is made up of what? Atoms. You have to remember that. Which participate in chemical reaction. So this is a very important thing. In a chemical reaction, not only element participate, the atoms inside every element, the atoms inside every compound also participate in a chemical reaction. You have to remember. For example, if we take an example, sodium is react with chlorine, then formation of sodium chloride. In this reaction, the atoms of sodium also react with the atoms of chlorine. You have to remember that atoms also participate in a chemical reaction. Not only sodium element and chlorine molecules, or not only these two react, also these atoms inside these elements and molecules also participate in a chemical reaction. So this is the first postulate of Dalton's atomic theory. And the second postulate is what? Atoms are indivisible particles. That means we cannot divide the atoms, which cannot be created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. So this, the second postulate, is a little bit similar. Little bit means 100% is similar with the conservation of mass we have studied. What is the conservation of mass? Conservation of mass we have studied states that mass cannot be created, or destroyed in a chemical reaction. So here also have atoms are indivisible particles which cannot be created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. So what? So these postulates, the second number postulates, identify our law of conservation of mass. Always remember that. And after that, our postulates number three, atoms of a given element are identical in mass and chemical properties. In a given element, say sodium have an atom, sodium also have some atoms, and these atoms, every atom have same properties. Every atom, say four sodium have, say, suppose it's not four atom, suppose sodium have four atom, and if the properties and mass of this, all these four atoms are similar according to this three number postulates. Atoms of a given element identical in mass, that is mass also same, and chemical properties also same in this all atoms of a given compound, only one compound. And the three number postulate is finished. And after that, atoms of different element have different masses and chemical properties. That means this this inverse of this the third postulate, atoms of different element have different masses. Atoms of same element, that means given element, are identical in mass. Atoms of different element have different mass and chemical properties. That means chemical properties also different. That means two elements, hydrogen and oxygen, these two molecules, hydrogen molecule and oxygen molecule, have different masses and different chemical properties also. And after that, four number postulates, atoms of different element have different, this one done, Final postulates, atoms combine in the ratio of small whole number to form a compound. So to form a compound, atoms combine in the ratio of small whole number. So what is our second law, second chemical law? Our second chemical law is law of constant proportion. Do you remember the second our second law? Law of constant proportion. That means in a chemical reaction, law of constant proportion in a chemical reaction, chemical substance, the elements are always present in definite proportion. Elements are always present in definite proportion. These are second, our second law indicate, this postulate indicates our second law. Which postulates? Postulates number 5. Atoms combine in the ratio of small whole number to form a compound. Say hydrogen and oxygen always combine in the ratio 1:8. We have discussed about that. So about this things is given here, the 5 number postulate. And our last postulate, the relative number of kinds of atoms. The relative number of kinds of atoms are constant in a given compound. So in a compound, carbon dioxide in a compound, the relative number of atoms also present here. We'll discuss about how to calculate the relative atomic number. We'll discuss about this in the next chapter. So you remember this 6 number postulate, the relative number of kinds of atoms are constant in a given compound. So now page number 33, have some questions. Question number 3, you see at your textbook, which postulates of Dalton's atomic theory is the result of law of conservation of mass? Question number 3, which postulate gives result of conservation of mass? I have told you that atoms are indivisible particle which cannot be created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. So question number 3 answer is postulate number which one? Postulate number 2 gives the answer of the question number 3. So you have to write the whole postulate in question number 3. And question number 4, what? Question number 4 also given, which postulates of Dalton's atomic theory can explain the law of definite proportion? I have told you, law of definite proportion combined in the ratio of small whole number to form a compound. This 5 number postulate gives is the answer of the question number 4. For postulate number which one? 5. So I will give the notes of these 2 questions. Don't write like that postulate number 2 and postulate number 5. You have to write the line of these postulates. Atoms are indivisible particles which cannot be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction, and atoms combine in the ratio of small whole number to form a compound. So our topic today is finished. We will study more in the next video. Thank you.